Hi folks, this is Brother Jerry Colston.
Hey, this is Brother Doug Chris.
And this is your Hometown Gospel Hour. And like we always say, Brother Doug, we're here to play some good hometown gospel singers. And we want to remind you again, if you have a tape or something and want to get it on here, well, give it to me or Brother Doug. And anyway, and who are you now? I was about to take off without introducing you.
That's right. I don't know if I did or not. I was sitting nodding with you. Somebody told me one time, they said, Doug, you look scared. You know, and I said, well, I'm not scared. I just, they got nothing to say. Folks, I'm Brother Doug Crisp. Appreciate you joining the Hometown Gospel Hour. Brother Jared, the show that features only hometown folk.
Yeah.
And like you were saying, the people that bring the tapes or CDs or videos to us, a lot of times they bring them and drop them off at Western Sizzling. And Brother Jerry, it's a place to bring your tapes and your CDs and videos. Just leave them for us there at the cash register. And speaking of Western Sizzling, Brother Jerry, I'll tell you what, when you go to prayer.
Yeah.
It's your turn.
Okay. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for the privilege that we have to come to you. You said in your word that we can come to you boldly, so help us, Father, to be bold as we come to you. But Lord, give us that humble spirit as we go among our brothers and sisters. We ask you now, Father, to bless this service today. Bless all of the listeners and the watchers out there. Bless all your people, wherever they might be. Go with us now and lead us and guide us in what we do here today. And whatever we might do or say, take it and use it for your honor and your glory. And we thank you for all that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right, now I can say now about Western Sizzling. We appreciate Western Sizzling, Brother Jerry, sponsoring the Hometown Gospel Hour. They've been with us since the beginning, and I really appreciate that. And Brother Jerry, a lot of great, exciting things going on there at Western Sizzling. Not only do we have that huge buffet where you can make a plate as big or as little as you'd like, Brother Jerry, as Brother Ronnie Kay says, we have the Holy Bird.
I see some of them stacked this high, too.
Yeah. But, you know, every day we have, as Brother Ronnie Kay says, the Holy Bird.
Yeah.
You know, fried chicken livers, homemade mashed potatoes, homemade macaroni and cheese, homemade pinto beans, homemade white beans, green beans. I mean, there's just a lot of stuff out there. And that's a standard, not including some days we have pork chops and homemade meatloaf and catfish. Mm-hmm. And just every day is just really different. But, Brother Jerry, don't forget, too, about our senior bar from 1 to 3.
Yeah.
All my senior buddies out there, love to invite you to come out and join us for that.
Yeah, and I, for one, can, you know, testify to the to the food because I'm in there quite a bit. And of course, our other sponsors, one of our old sponsors is Rogers Funeral Home, and it's, I believe, in the third generation of the Rogers family. And I knew Mr. Rogers years ago, and then his son took over, and then after he passed on, that was Marvin, of course. Marvin took over, and then after Marvin passed on, Jim now he's kind of in charge, and they're just good folks. They're friendly, they're family oriented, everything's just as it should be when you go there, and they have two chapels, one in South Pittsburgh and one in Jasper, and maybe you need to give them a call and. You know, all of us hate to think about dying, but it's going to happen, and maybe we all ought to make some arrangements ahead of time. Call them and talk to them, and also while you're talking to them, tell them you appreciate them sponsoring the gospel music.
Yes, sir. Hey, and Citizens State Bank, Brother Jerry, we appreciate them coming aboard. Brother Jerry, they've got locations, and you see them, they're on the screen. I mean, they've got all those locations. And Brother Jerry, they're owned and operated right here in Marion County.
Right, yeah.
And Brother Jerry, that says a lot when your money stays here in Marion County. And Brother Jerry, they offer services like, there's so much about a bank. You know, you think, well, a bank's just money, and there's just a lot more there to them.
Yeah.
Brother Jerry, they've got the free checking. They've got the free debit cards. I mean, it's just a lot of stuff. And Brother Jerry, when I need a loan, that's who I go see is Citizens State Bank because they treat you right, Brother Jerry.
They're your friends.
They are. Uh-huh. They're people that you depend on because they're people that, Brother Jerry, that you eat breakfast with, that we eat lunch with every day.
I mean, we see them out on the street all the time.
That's it. You know, and you don't see bank executives like that.
But no.
Brother Jerry, the people that own the bank live right here with
that's
us.
That's right. They
do. So support your local businesses.
That's right.
All right.
Heart knows within Our God will not judge us on how big or how small. He looks for Calvary's blood to cover it all. Oh, the blood. Of his precious blood, it covers.
So echoes from the burning bush. His love songs tell every word to our soul. Sweet to me echoes from the burning bush.
Oh, I got it in the manger that all country children sing. The song of praise, the praise, how the people would sing. It would make the heavens sing, and that all country children shall sing, and the man, the river, the beautiful, the beautiful river, and the wind will say, and the river, and the Father God above. Oh, again, the forgive, and that all country church have the glory of the Lord. Amen, amen, amen. And the children with smile as they shout at the hour of that all that old country church will see by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. It will sleep by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. And on Sunday to see all my friends and there to be and that old country church.
All right, Brother Doug, that was some good singing, and of course that was Victory Baptist Church Choir with the old country church. And that's what they are up there, isn't it?
Yes, sir. And the Webbs, Brother Jerry, with the echoes.
Yeah, and Yvonne Horn with the hand.
The blood covered it all.
It's written right there, and I... he writes it down so I can remember, and then I can't read it. Okay.
Well, folks, join us now for a segment we like to call Who Wants to Be a Bible Scholar?
And at the same time, Brother Doug calls it in his heart, let me stump Brother Jerry today.
So, you know, the Bible says to study, to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. And when this is just for fun, Brother Jerry, we don't claim to be Bible scholars or nothing.
And we
like
don't
that.
Give a grade on it, do we?
No. So, folks, join us for Who Wants to Be a Bible Scholar?
All right. Here we go. Yeah.
I'm starting to get that frog in my throat.
We both got a frog today for some reason.
jumped on me.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. First question. Who is not accepted in his own country?
Uh-huh.
Was it A, a missionary? Is it B, a prophet? Is it C, leopards? Or is it D, physicians?
All right.
The second question. After Jesus had cried with a loud voice when he was on the cross, who did they say he called for? Was it A, the angels? Was it B, God? Was it C, Elijah? Or is it D, his mother?
Uh-huh. Good questions.
Sir.
I'm trying to get them registered here as you go.
And if you can see there too, folks, we got the, if you don't know it, you can look it up there, the Bible verses there on the screen. All right, Brother Jerry, the third question. Whose wife did David marry after he died? Was it A, Nabal? Was it B, Saul? Was it C, Abishai? Was it D, Goliath?
Whoa.
Okay. The next question. Who was the prophet during Hezekiah's reign? Remember King Hezekiah?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Was it A, Elisha? Was it B, Isaiah? Was it C, Daniel? Or is it D, John? So how you doing so far? You know, the Bible says to study, to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Mm-hmm.
All right. The next question. Which book in the Bible does not mention the Lord's name? Was it A, Ruth? Was it B, Esther? Was it D, Hosea? Or was it D, Amos?
I'll tell you right now, you got me on that one. I can't. Okay. I don't know of a book of the Bible that doesn't mention God somewhere.
All right. And then the sixth question, the last question. Who was Joseph, the husband of Mary's dad? Was it A, David? Was it B, Joseph Sr.? Was it C, Jacob? Or was it D, Hezekiah? So how y'all doing so far? You know, once again, the Bible says to study, to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
You must have a book that the title of it is Things to Puzzle Brother Jerry with.
No, I wish I had a book. I got to study these myself. So, folks, got a great show coming up for you, Brother Jerry. Got some great music coming up, Brother Jerry. Yeah. So here is Touch of Grace with Meeting in the Air.
Right here on your hometown gospel hour.
Thank you. I can hear them softly whisper, here comes Jesus. Such compassion did he show for the crowd. I can see him carefully listening to a cripple by a pool. Have mercy, Lord, and help me now while the water is being moved. Arise and walk today. Victory is here to stay. For with God, nothing shall be so impossible. You're free from sin and fear, the words belong to me. It was a very special moment. It was a very happy day. I can see God's holy angels coming for me. Very soon they'll place me in a cold grave. But that won't even hold me on that final day when Jesus steps out on the clouds and I hear our Savior say,
arise and live today. Victory is here to stay. For with God, nothing shall be so impossible. You're free from sin and fear, the words belong to thee.
It will be a happy moment. It's gonna be a special moment.
It will be a happy day.
Wound up that section with the Taylors with Arise.
Yeah, and their low-down friends, the Tonys, with I Saw the Light.
I don't see those low-down boys as much as they used to, but they can flat sing low, I know.
Well, you know, the church got blown away during the...
I didn't know that.
During the tornado.
Oh, yes, I did, too, and, because they went to Kimball.
You know, and nobody in that church was hurt. Well, now, you know, they moved over to the building across the street there where the... furniture store used to be.
Yeah.
And they're looking to build a new church, but Brother Aaron, he keeps me informed about them.
Oh, good.
But pray for that church, too, Major. Yeah. I know they've got a lot going on.
They
right
do,
now.
Yeah. And, of course, the first song we started out with was Touch of Grace with The Meeting in the Air.
Yeah. So. All right, well, folks, how did y'all do on Who Wants to Be a Bible Scholar? We got some great questions, and Brother Jerry ain't had time to look it up here.
No, I'm not...
But, you know, the Bible says...
Study to show yourself approved, so...
A workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. That's 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15. First question we asked Brother Jerry was, who is not accepted in his own country? Was it A, a missionary? Was it B, a prophet? Was it C, leopards? Or was it D, a physician?
Okay, that was where Christ was trying to preach around where his relatives and friends lived, and they questioned him, you know, about who did he think he was, you know, we know. And, of course, the way he said it, he said, a prophet is not accepted. You know, I remember him, you know, reading that he said that.
All right, well, ding, score one for Brother Jerry. All right, so how did you do? The next question was after Jesus had cried with a loud voice when he was on the cross, you know, when he said, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? who did they say he called for? Was it A, the angels? Was it B, God? Was it C, Elijah? Or was it D, his mother?
Yeah, and that one, he wrote it, I mean, he when he said it, the King James Version translated it as Elias, but Elijah was what it was from.
All right. Yeah. Well, then, two for Brother Jerry.
Yeah. So far, so good.
So far, so good.
I think you're getting down into some names now.
So, folks, how are y'all doing so far? The third question, whose wife did David marry after he died? Was it A, Nabal? Was it B, Saul? Was it C, Abishai? Or is it D, Goliath?
Who did David marry after he died? I mean, after he died. Sounds like after David
died. Well, not after David died.
And the, let's see. Well, I know he took a man's wife, but his name wasn't in there, so. I don't know who he married.
Well, the story, Brother Jerry, was after, it's been a while since I've studied it, so yeah. Bear with me. But anyway, there was a man that owned a lot of camels. He was a Camelite or something like that, they called him. His name was Nabal.
Okay,
Nabal was a Camelite. And David had came to him. I don't remember if it was for help or something. But anyway, he said, hey, I don't have nothing to do with this guy. You know?
Yeah.
Well, God got upset with him. So Nabal's wife, Abigail, I forgot her name right off, but she goes and confronts David. She says, look, don't have mercy upon my husband. You know, he doesn't understand and whatnot. So David found mercy upon her.
Well,
10 days later, God smote Nabal. And then David, realizing that she was such a just woman, came and took her as his wife, his second wife. His first wife was Saul's daughter.
Yeah.
But, is that right?
He had so many wives, that's one thing, too.
I think that was, Saul had given her. And then when he came back, it seemed like Saul had given that daughter that he gave to David, gave it to another man after they'd already been married.
You know, the whole thing goes back to Bathsheba, you know. Yeah. But she wasn't his first nor his last either. She was just one of them.
She was just in there.
She was just in there.
You know, but the thing about that is even though they had great sin, you know, and God had took that baby, but even though they had sinned and whatnot, they had asked for forgiveness. Mm-hmm. God still blessed it and gave him Solomon.
Yeah, and well, you know, when the baby died, David repented in sackcloth and ashes. He got as low as he could possibly get.
Yeah.
So
you know, he said, "I can't go. He can't come to me, but I can go back in."
And so the Lord took him at his word and forgave him.
So that's how we are. Even though there's times, Brother Jerry, in our lives that we've sinned. You know, if you'll ask God, he can still take
that's
that.
That's right, yeah.
He can still make something blessing out of it. I know
that's
a lot
right.
of times we have daughters and sisters and whatnot that have children out of wedlock, and you think it's just the worst thing in the world, but sometimes God has a plan for that.
Yeah.
And, you know, he will bless it, you know.
Yeah, you hear it said sometimes today, and I believe it. There's no such thing as an accident. You know, when a child is born, it's meant from the Lord. That's why I'm so, I guess, so adamant against this abortion business.
Yeah.
It's a gift from God. A baby is.
I feel like Brother Jerry, somebody's watching this right now that is facing this right now, and I had a cousin, Brother Jerry, that. Her and her sister and her mom and dad, they were driving to the abortion clinic. And she said, you know, if there's five of us going, but only four of us coming back. And so she told him, she said, let's go back home. And that little boy has been such a blessing to that family. And I mean, and what he does in church, I mean, it's just amazing.
That's right.
So God can take this trial and make a blessing.
That's right.
All right, the next question, Brother Jerry, was, who was the prophet during Hezekiah's reign? Remember King Hezekiah and the revival that he took and demolished the temple worship and whatnot, cleaned the temple out? Was who was that prophet? Was it A, Elisha? Was it B, Isaiah? Was it C, Daniel? Or is it D, John?
I'm not certain on this, but I think it was Daniel, was it? Am I wrong?
Well, the one I was thinking of was Isaiah, because, you know, he was a prophet during that time.
You know how I am with names in the Old Testament.
Because I think it was, I don't think Daniel was born then. Okay. Now, I could be wrong. Well, we'll have to study up on that a little bit more. He might have been in that. I don't think Daniel was mentioned in the Book of Kings.
I really can't remember. I just was taking a wild stab at it there.
But the one I was looking for was Isaiah.
Yeah, okay.
So he was the one that, and I think Jeremiah was a prophet in that also during that time. All right, the next question we ask, which book in the Bible does not mention the Lord? Was it A, the Book of Ruth? Was it B, the Book of Esther? Was it C, the Book of Hosea? Or was it D, the Book of Amos?
I don't have the slightest idea, so you want me to just take a stab?
Take a stab.
I kind of believe it would be Ruth.
Good guess. But if you remember, even in the Book of Ruth, it said that she, her daughter-in-law, no, she was the daughter-in-law. Her mother-in-law was,
Oh man, senior moment.
your senior moment had come off on me. It's here, Naomi.
Naomi, yeah.
Naomi.
Common name in there.
So anyway, Naomi was the mother-in-law. Ruth was the daughter-in-law. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
Ruth had married Naomi's son, and then she had another daughter-in-law, but the sons had gotten killed, and so she said that, go on to your own people. And she said, no. She said, where thou go, I will go. Where thou lodgest, I will lodge. And so, and I'll go to be with thy people. But it's Esther.
Esther, okay.
Now, if you remember, do you remember the story of Esther?
Yeah, she saved their lives by going into the king and so on, you know, if I'm not mistaken. That's, you know, I remember some of the highlights. But
yeah, so basically that's it. She saved the people back then, but the Lord's never mentioned in the Book of Ruth.
Well,
and the Book of Esther, sorry.
Yeah, well, I was thinking Ruth because it's in more of a poetic story type, you know, and I didn't, my memory's not all that good either.
Mine must be coming off with my hair. All right, the last question.
My head's drooping.
All right, the last question we asked was, who was Joseph, the husband of Mary's dad? Was it A, David? Was it B, Joseph Sr.? Was it C, Jacob? Or was it D, Hezekiah?
I've read that lineage and so on, but I can't remember. But it sounds like it ought to be Hezekiah.
Okay. Well, now Hezekiah was his great, 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 great granddad.
He was too far up the line.
He's either 7, 8, 9. He was somewhere. He's great.
He was in the line somewhere.
But that's the same Hezekiah we talked about in Isaiah.
Yeah.
But it was Jacob.
His Joseph's daddy was Jacob.
Yeah, Jacob.
But it wasn't the Jacob from back in the Old Testament.
No, but it was just another. Yeah. See, back then they carried on sometimes their same names.
Mm-hmm.
But,
boy, I didn't do so hot today.
So, folks, how did y'all do? You know, the Bible says to study, to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Brother Jerry, here's a great old song here sung by a great old person. Death ain't no big deal.
Right here on your hometown gospel hour.
Someday when I breathe my final breath, the doctor takes one look and says, you're dead. The truth is gonna finally be revealed. Oh, I'm gonna find death ain't no big deal. Well, he'll reach down and gently close my eyes, and I'll be watching from the other side. I'll be laughing about how scared I thought I'd be. Just like a bird set free, I'll sail right past the moon up to the stars. And I know I'll be amazed when I get to heaven's gate. I knew my way home by heart. good I'll feel. Oh, I tell you, children, death ain't no big deal. My soul is gonna be just like a bird set free. I'll sail right past the moon up to the stars. And I know I'll be amazed when I get to heaven's gate. I knew my way home by heart. Well, the light will shine much brighter than the sun. And I'll be right back where I started from. Oh, there ain't no way to say how good I'll feel. Oh, I tell you, children, death ain't no big deal. At my Savior's feet, I'm gonna kneel. Oh, I thank you, Lord. Death ain't no big deal.
Back several years ago, there was a guy got him a job driving a milk wagon, went house to house. And one morning he pulled up to this house and there was a note in the milk bottle that said, "Mr. Milkman, leave me 12 gallons of milk this morning." Well, he said that just didn't seem right, so he knocked on the door and the lady came. "Claudette, this might suit you." Lady came to the door and he said, "Ma'am, are you sure you want 12 gallons of milk?" She said, "Yep." He said, "Well, what are you going to do with it?" And she said, "Well, I've always heard that if you took a milk bath, it was good for your complexion." He said, "Well, that sounds reasonable." So he started walking away and he stopped. He said, "Oh, ma'am, did you want that pasteurized?" She said, "No, about waist high and I'll splash it in my eyes." Smith family.
Thank you.
so aimless, filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I am happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man I wandered along. Worries and fears I claim for my own. Then like a blind man, God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I am happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I was a fool to wander astray. Straight is the way and narrow the gate. Now I have traded the wrong for the right. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I am happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
I want you to listen to this one here. This is my daughter. And she does a beautiful job on this song. And, you know, if the Lord looked at us and judged us for what we do every day, we wouldn't have a chance. But the song says he looked beyond our faults and saw what we needed.
Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise, for it was grace that bought my liberty. I do not know just why he came to love me so. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need.
I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary, to view the cross where Jesus died for me. My falling soul.
He looked beyond my faults and saw my need. I never knew such love as this would ever be, till he redeemed my soul and set me free. His precious Spirit now abides within my heart. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need.
I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary, to view the cross for me. How marvelous the grace that caught my falling soul.
He looked beyond
for me.
How marvelous the grace that caught my falling soul.
He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs.
Thank the Western Sizzling for giving us this opportunity. There's a lot of places in the world today that gospel singing is out of style, and we're proud that they do. And like I told you a while ago, Doug and I have a TV program. We play gospel music, and the Western Sizzling is one of our sponsors, in fact the oldest sponsor that we've got. So we really appreciate them, and we appreciate you coming tonight, and we appreciate your attention. And we appreciate these people that have come tonight and sung for you, because all they're getting out of it is just the satisfaction of doing something for the Lord and for the cancer. Make them welcome, if you will, Kyle Lewis and Brother Shrunk.
This world is not our permanent dwelling. We have a bed.
Told me one time that there was a dog had a name in the Bible.
Oh, really?
I said, a dog with a name. He said, sure. He said, right here it is. And it was where the cripple was laying outside the rich man's gate.
Yeah.
And he said he sat there by the gate, you know, to catch crumbs, and said, moreover, the dog. I said, well, it says moreover, the dog came. But that wasn't the dog's name, but it was kind of, I got a good laugh out of it.
It might have been, so moreover the dog. So moreover, there's one you can ask your pastor this Sunday.
Do you know who moreover is? Brother Doug, are we out of time?
We are out of time, Brother Jay.
Folks, this is Brother Jay Colston, and I'll just sign off the way I always do. If I don't meet you again on the air, I hope to meet you in the air. And until we do meet again, good night. God bless you, and remember us in your prayers.
Yes, sir. Brother Doug, Chris, pray for us, and we'll pray for you.
Good night.